You are welcome to our video tutorial. So in this tutorial we are going to be talking about what the basic laws of what indices. This lecture was presented and prepared by what learners this group. Please don't forget to like and share our videos. Visit our page, our web page, our Facebook page and our Twitter account for more updates. Laws of indices. In the symbol x to the power of what n, x is the base and n is what the index. So index is singular, while indices is plural. So either you call it what index or you call it what exponent. However, the basic laws of indices, where x the base is not equal to zero, as stated in the books of what indices. So indices, lots of indices have what, let's say 5 to 8 basic rules. These rules were around 5, but we decided to expand it to 8 just to make it easier for our viewers. So the rule number 1, whenever I have what x to the power of what a is multiplying what x to the power of b, now my bases are the same. Since the two bases are the same, it means, and I'm multiplying, it means I will add my powers. Rule number 1, whenever the two bases are the same and I'm supposed to multiply what the two values, I will take one of the bases, both of them are the same, then I will add what my powers. Rule number 2, if since for multiplication I have what addition, then for division I'll subtract. So whenever I have two values that the bases are the same and they are carrying what index, and I'm supposed to divide them, then it means I should what, subtract the powers. Since the base are the same, I'll just take one of the base, then subtract the powers. Rule number 3, whenever I have what, two index, x is carry index A and then another index B. Since A and B are both index and is bracket that is combining the two index, then it means I should what multiply what the two index. So I have x to the power of A to the power of B. It means x to the power of what A is multiplying B, which will give me what AB. Then rule number 4 say that x to the power of 0 is 1. X to the power of 0 is 1. So it means A to the power of 0 will be 1. 1 million to the power of 0 is 1. Then rule number 5 is talking about whenever I have what a negative index, this negative here is going to form what 1 all over my negative here, you form 1 all over, then I have what x to the power of what a. Rule number 6, whenever I have what a base which is carry what a fractional index. A fractional index. So the numerator is going to form what the index, or you call it what the power, while the denominator will form what the root. So here I have x to the power of what 1 all over a, which will give me my 1 will form what my power here, and my denominator will form what my root. So that's why I have what x to the power of what 1 all over what a, which give me what cube 8 root of what x to the power of what 1. Then the rule number 7, rule number 7 is still talking about fractional index just like this, but the only difference is that my numerator and denominator have what values. So x to the power of what a over b, like what I said earlier, my numerator is going to form what the power of my base, while the denominator will form what the root of the entire value. So x to the power of what a over b equals b root of what x to the power of what power of a. Rule number 8 is combining rule number 5 and rule number 7. So combine these two rules will form what rule number 8. So rule number is talking about negative fractional index. Don't forget from here, this negative form what 1 all over, 1 all over, then I will have what my index. So if I have x to the power of what minus a all over b equals minus, will give me what, 1 all over, then my a, which is numerator, will form what, the power, while my b will form the fraction, or we form what, the root, form the root. So let's go to what our solved example. Simplify 7 to the power of 2 by 7 to the what, power of 3. Don't forget, from rule number 1, when the powers are the same, okay, solution, I decide to repeat my question. Now, when the bases are the same, I decide to take one. Since I'm multiplying, then it means I should add what, my powers. So 7 to the power of 2 plus 3 should give me 7 to what, to the power of what, 5. Don't forget, this one is from what, rule number 1. That's example number 1. Then example number 2. I was told to simplify 8 over 27 the power of what, 2 over 3. Looking at this, it means the rules we are supposed to use to solve this question are what? Rule number 7. But you can say to see is rule number 6, but they are the same thing. Okay, just apply rule number 7 to solve what? Example 2. So I have this solution. I decided to repeat my question. Equals, open bracket, I said my numerator is going to form the power. So this 2 here is forming square, is power. Why the denominator will form what? A cube root. So I have 8 over 27, which is my value. My numerator will form the power, and denominator will form what? The cube root. So this will give me, I have 2 over 3 here to the power of square. Don't forget, this will give me 2 to the power of 3. 8 is same as what, 2 to the power of 3. So this cube root will remove that 3 and we have 2. Then 3 to the power of 3 is what, 27. So 3 to the power of 3, that index 3, will remove the cube root and we have what, 3. So what I did here was to try to break this down to make them to have index in order to what, to remove what, the cube root. So this gave me 2 to the power of 3. That 3 there will remove this cube root. Why 27 is 3 to the power of 3. The cube there will remove what, this. So we have what, 2 all over 3. Then my square. Then squaring this, 2 square will give me 4. And 9, 3 square will give me what, 9. 2 square, 4 and 3 square, 9. That is for that. That is what, example number 2. Example number 3. I was told to simplify 32n to the power of what, 1 over 5. 32n to the power of what, 1 over 5. Which means my 32 is carry 1 over 5 and my n is carry 1 over 5. So I can decide, after repeating my question, it means this, expanding this, that we have 32 is carry a fractional index, which is what, 1 all over 5, multiplied by what, n is carry what, another fractional index, which was 1 all over 5. Don't forget, this rule, we said is what, don't forget, we said, it's rule number 6. So it's rule number 6, we are going to what, apply to what, that what, question. So, I have my 32 to the power of 1 all over 5 multiplied by n to the power of 1 all over 5. So, my index, which is the numerator, will form what, my power. So, I have 32 to the power of 1. What the denominator will form what? The fifth root. Then multiply by what? N. The numerator will form what? My index. So, I have n to the power of 1. Why the denominator will form what? My fifth root. So, from here, this 32 is same as what, 2 to the power of 5. 2 to the power of 5 will give me 32. So that 5 will remove the 5 here, which we make me, don't forget, what I'm saying here is, by 2, which is what, 1 2 3 4 5. I have 1 2 3 4 5. So this is 32. Counting them, this will give me 2 to the power of what, 5. So this 5 is going to remove this 5, which make me to have what? Just a single 2. Single 2 multiplied by what? Why this can still be returned back to this. So from here, I will want to multiply them together. Now, this is 2 and the base here is n. They are not the same. So it means I'm not going to add the powers. Since they are not the same, I'll just want to multiply them directly. Example number 3. So example number 4. I have 3 to the power of what? 3x equals 81 to the power of what? 3 over 4. So this is a question that I was told, that I was given. I was told to find what x, the value of what x solution. I said to repeat my question. So 3 to the power of 3x equals 81. Don't forget, since there is 3 here, okay, I can decide to break 81 down since I'm having what, a denominator. So it's good I look for what, a value that will easily cancel out this 4. So I think of a number. What number can 2 carry to give me 81? No number, but 3 can carry 4 to give me 81. So instead of writing 81, I split 81 into what? 3 to what? Power 4. Don't forget, this is same as writing 3 by 3. So I have 3 in 4 places, which should give me 3 to what? Power of what? 4. Give me 3 to the what? Power of 4. Then now, okay, opening this, applying rule number 3. So applying rule number 3, I have this, both of them are index and this bracket that is binding them, so I will multiply them. So this will give me what? AB. So it means I should apply that same rule here. So it means I will have 4 is multiplied with 3 all over 4, which is this. Go for this bracket as what binded them. So I have 3 to the power of 4, 3s equals 3 to the power of 4 multiplied by 3 all over 4. So 4 can knock out 4 here, which will give me 3 to the power of what? 3. Then looking at this, I have 3 to the power of 3s equals 3. Don't you think these two bases are the same? And definitely they can cancel out. So since this 3 here and this base are the same, they can cancel out. Or one of the rule of indices is that when two values are the same and they are having two same bases, then it means the index are the same. When we have what equation having what, maybe a value and an index, whenever what the two b's are the same, then it means what, the index are the same, because what is equal to sign. Or whenever what the index are the same, then it means what, the b's are the same. But the one we are going to apply here is that the b's are the same, which means the index are the same. So since base 3 equals base 3, then it means what, 3x equals what, this 3 here. So I will divide both sides by the coefficient of x, since I'm looking for x. So I divide both sides by 3. I will have 3 over 3, which will give me 1. 3 over 3, which will give me x. And 3 over 3 here will give me what? 1. So we have come to the end of our tutorial. End of section. Hope the lesson was beneficial. Please like and share our videos and don't forget to comment below. Take your quiz to proceed to the next lesson. Try to have minimum of 50% to have what. So from here we draw the curtain. Don't forget to try to view our other videos. Bye.